Hello everyone, welcome to Sujitra's online reading channel. Many times we wonder what Lord Krishna's age was. Actually, Lord Krishna seemed to be the real God of nature who was beyond the limits of nature. In historical depictions of the Puranas, he did not seem to age even after decades. In one incident, Duryodhana tried to arrest Krishna where his body burst open, showing all creations within him. Such was his manifestation and power. Let's move on to today's episode, Brahma's Illusion. One afternoon, Krishna was sitting among his friends in the jungle. He was tasting dishes of each of his friends with their hands. Lord Brahma saw this all. He felt envious. Even gods and celestial beings were not fortunate enough to enjoy such a close relationship with the Lord. Lord Brahma decided to put the Lord to a test. As the gopas were enjoying their lunch, Lord Brahma with his powers made the cattle stray. The gopas got up to look for the calves. At this, Krishna said to them, "Finish your lunch while I shall go and look for the calves. I have already finished my lunch." Now, Brahma had shut all the calves in a cave. When Krishna went to look for them, Brahma with his powers also hid the gopas in the same cave. Then he returned to the heaven, amused with the thought that he would come to the earth the next day to look at the condition of Krishna. When Krishna could not find the calves anywhere, he returned to the spot where he had been with his friends. But to his amazement, there was no one. After a little meditation, he came to know that it was the mischief of Brahma. He decided to play a trick and revert the joke to Brahma. Krishna did not make any efforts to release his friends and the calves. Instead, he multiplied himself and took the forms of his friends and calves. These forms of the Lord were so perfect that nobody could find out any difference. As the sun set, all the gopas and the calves, who were actually the forms of the Lord himself, set off towards the village. On reaching the village, all the Krishna Gopa bid farewell to Krishna and entered their houses with their Krishna calves. Krishna had so minutely copied them that even their mothers could not recognize them. This impersonation continued for 1 year. Every morning, Krishna Gopas and Krishna calves would go to the pastures with Krishna himself, and in the evening they would return back home after playing and enjoying themselves a lot the whole day. The mothers would pamper their sons and would take care of them. They were reluctant to send them to the pastures in the morning. The cows also loved their calves. They could not stop licking them. Thus Krishna enjoyed the love and tender care of many parents and animals at the same time. He also gave happiness and pleasure to all the mothers. The other gods and celestial beings watched this wonderful deed of the Lord. One day, when Krishna, Balarama and Krishna Gopas reached the pastures with the Krishna calves, the cows, who were already grazing on the hill slopes of Govardhan, came running to their calves and started licking them. Seeing this, Balarama inquired Krishna, "Krishna, could you tell what has happened to all the mothers and cows of Vrindavan?" Krishna then told Balaram the whole incident, how Brahma tried to pull his legs and how he got paid back in the same coin. By now, 1 year had gone by. 1 year on earth is equal to 1 day in the heaven. So when Brahma came to the earth to see what had happened to Krishna, 1 year had already passed. He felt very disappointed to see Krishna playing with gopas in the green pastures. He quietly rushed to the cave where he found the gopas and calves asleep as he had left them. He thought, "I think Lord has created Maya." As soon as he acknowledged this, like a mist clearing, he saw Krishna all around himself. Then Brahma alighted from his swan and circumambulated Lord Krishna. Bowing in front of the Lord, he said, "My Lord, your powers are stronger than those of mine. I humbly accept my defeat." He sang hymns in praise of the Lord. Then Brahma returned to the heaven, and all the divine forms of Krishna Gopas and Krishna calves vanished. All the Gopa boys and calves returned to their previous position from which Brahma had picked them up, but he had cast a spell on them, as a result of which they did not remember anything that had happened. The calves were grazing in the pastures, and the gopas continued to play with Krishna as if they had never been separated. Thus was the Leela of the Lord. So that's all for today. I will come up with the next episode tomorrow. Until then, see you. Bye-bye.